हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर एस के सोनोने फ्रॉम केके वा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर नासिक। टुडे वी विल सी द प्रेजेंटेशन अंडर द कोर्स माइबो 111 एंड कोर्स टाइटल इंट्रोडक्टरी माइक्रोबायोलॉजी। माय टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन टॉपिक इज माइक्रोबियल वर्ल्ड। प्रीवियसली वी सी इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी एंड scope and importance of microbiology in agriculture and allied fields, as well as we see in the definition of microbiology. What is mean by microbiology? It is the deals with the study of microorganisms, means the study of different microorganisms are included in the overall microbiology. Then today we see microbial world, means different microorganisms and their characters, how they grow, how they multiply, and where they are present. First one, introduction of microbial world. Before the 1886, there were only two kingdoms. Then in the 1886, German zoologist E.H. Haeckel proposed third kingdom, that is protista or protists, contains only unicellular microbes. Protista contains two types of protista, lower protista and higher protista. Lower protista contain bacteria, higher protista contain algae, fungi and protozoa. Next, there are two cells, that is eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. Eukaryotic means fungus, algae, and prokaryotes means bacteria. Next one, these are the different microorganisms included in microbiology. We see one by one the characters of algae, fungi, bacteria, actinomycetes, mycoplasma, viruses, protozoa, and nematodes. First one, general characteristics of algae. Algae are the simple aquatic plant. Primitive algae are unicellular, but most other multicellular filamentous. Exception is large brown kelp alga, which has a complex body structure with specialized type of algae specific function. In brown kelp algae, it has a complex body structure for specialized specific functions. Algal cells contain chlorophyll, therefore are capable of photosynthesis. They make their own food. Naturally, they are aquatic in habitat and present in damp soils. Then the general characteristics of fungus. Fungi are achlorophyllous, means lack of chlorophyll, therefore are unable to synthesize their own food. They are not capable to synthesize their own food because of absence of chlorophyll. The fungal thallus or body may be unicellular or multicellular filamentous. Exceptionally, the fungi have complex vegetative structure as found in puffballs and mushrooms. Fungi reproduce asexually or sexually or by both the ways. If they produce asexually, either by fission, budding or orthospores in special asexual fruiting bodies, and if they are reproduced by sexually, by oospores, zygospores, ascospores or basidiospores. Fungi are economically important because they produce both beneficial as well as harmful effects. Beneficial fungi employ the production of cheese, alcohol, acids, antibiotics and vitamins. As well as harmful fungi, they cause diseases in plants, animals and human beings. They are responsible for deterioration of food, fiber, lumber and leather. As we see in the previous, beneficial fungus used in dairy industries and pharmaceutical industries, as well as the harmful fungus causes diseases in plant, animals, humans, and responsible for spoilage of foods. Then the two things of fungus that we should know, that is single filamentous thread of the fungal body is called as hypha, and group of hypha is called as mycelium. These both the definitions are important for your final theory examination, so you have to short note. Next one, general characteristics of bacteria. These are microscopic prokaryotic unicellular microorganism with rigid cell wall. This is the definition of bacteria. They vary in shape from spherical, it's called cocci, rod shape, that is called bacilli, or helical shape. Bacteria shows a typical grouping of cell arrangements. They may be motile or non-motile. If they are motile, they move with flagellum or flagella. Bacteria are used flagella or flagellum for their movement from one place to another place. Bacteria reproduce asexually or sexually or by both the phase. Bacteria reproduce asexually either by binary fission or budding. Binary fission and budding are the asexual reproduction methods in bacteria. Then bacteria reproduce sexually either by conjugation, transformation, and transduction. These three are the reproducing methods of sexual reproduce method of bacteria, that is conjugation, transformation, and transduction. Bacteria are useful in storing of milk, and some are harmful which cause diseases in plants, animals, and human beings. Good example of bacteria which are beneficial to agriculture are rhizobium species, which fix the atmospheric nitrogen in leguminous root nodule symbiotically. Azotobacter species fixes atmospheric nitrogen without the help of any plant, therefore called as asymbiotic bacteria. With the few exceptions, most of the bacteria without chlorophyll. True bacteria cannot be filtered through bacteria-proof filters. Next one, general characteristics of actinomycetes. Morphologically, actinomycetes fall between fungi and bacteria. Okay, actinomycetes are not fungus as well as not a bacteria. They fall between both fungus and bacteria. These are gram-positive prokaryotic and aerobic-like bacteria. This is the definition of actinomycetes. These are gram-positive prokaryotic and aerobic-like bacteria. Their special features is the formation of branch filamentous. For example, Streptomyces species. Like bacteria, they have no distinct cell wall. General characteristics of mycoplasma. These are filterable microbes of unique morphology. Mycoplasma having a unique morphology, these are filterable microbes. These are ultra microscopic, therefore can be seen only by electron microscope. These are highly pleomorphic and can therefore mold their body due to absence of rigid cell wall. They are insensitive to penicillin but sensitive to tetracycline. They can be grown on culture media. Next, four forms have been noticed in growth cycle, namely budding forms, chains, elongated, and filamentous forms. They are susceptible to osmotic pressure. Their growth is very slow and can be inhibited by specific antisera. Both RNA and DNA are present in the mycoplasmal cell. They cause diseases like citrus greening, sandal spike, sesamum phyllodi, and little leaf of brinjal, bunchy top of papaya, and several other yellows disease. Then the general characteristics of viruses. These are filterable nucleoproteinases, self-replicating molecules, obligately parasitic in the living cells of plant or animals. Viruses contains either DNA or RNA, but never both. As we see in the mycoplasmal, both the RNA and DNA are present in the mycoplasmal cell, but in case of viruses, only DNA or RNA is present, never both contents are present. Being filterable, they can be passed through the bacteria-proof filters. They are filterable, therefore they can pass through the bacteria-proof filters. Being ultra-microscopic, they are very small in size, ranging from 20 to 300 nanometer, and can be seen only with electron microscope. Being obligate parasite, they can replicate or multiply only in living plant cells or animals. Plant viruses are either rod shape or polyhedral in shape. The typical rod shape virus, that is tobacco mosaic virus, is internally made up of ribonucleic acid spirals. Nucleic acid spirals are covered by embedded protein subunits. A virus particle is more properly called as virion. A single virus particle, it is known as the virion. The helical nucleic acid, it is called as nucleoid. The protein coat is called as capsid. The capsid consists of protein subunits, which are called as caps. In the as shown in picture, the morphology of viruses. Next one. General characteristics of protozoa. These are single cell animals. Their size varies from 2 to 20 micron meter. They make their movements by cilia, flagella, or pseudopodia. They reproduce asexually by fission as well as sexually by union of two mating types. They cause diseases like diarrhea and sleeping sickness in human beings and animals, and play varied role in nature. Protozoa is also called as eukaryotic organism. Common genera are amoeba, paramecium, and verticella. Species are differentiated on the basis of morphological, nutritional, and physiological characteristics. Then next one, general characteristics of nematode. They belong to class Nematoda. They are ubiquitous in nature, mostly infest soil. Almost all nematodes feed on living organisms like higher plants, fungi, bacteria, insects, and animals. Plant nematodes cannot be cultivated on artificial media or in vitro. Definition of nematodes: they are cylindrical, elongated, multicellular worms, unsegmented, colorless, parasitic nematodes. Possesses sucking stylet, which is absent in non-parasitic. Its size varies between 100 to 1000 micron meter. Nematodes are cylindrical, enclosed multicellular worms. They are unsegmented and they are colorless. नेक्स्ट वन, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग।